All right, hey guys, OFD checking in here, and today we have another new release from AVI-8 watches. Now, I've had a number of AVI-8 watches here on the channel, and I've had a number from the P-51 Mustang series. This is going to be another one of these, and this, to be honest with you guys, is one of my favorite ones. So let's go ahead and unbox and get it open. Now, the official release date or the unveiling date on these was the 30th of July, so I just missed that by a couple of days. But these are not actually going to be available. Oops, dropping everything there. They're not going to be available until the 6th of August for actual order. So I want to show you guys the box here real quick before how it has the P-51 Mustang layout there and stuff. Very cool. I love that look on the box. It definitely adds to that aviation flavor of the watch here. So you've got further or faster, further, higher from AVI-8. There is a code there if you guys want to scan it to go right over to their affiliate program or anything like that. Here's the information here, and on the back, hi Aron, we're so excited to hear your thoughts on the P-51 Mustang timepiece. And I am excited to see this one, guys. This one is the Hitchcock model, named after Tommy Hitchcock Jr. Guys, he was a famous World War II pilot. He actually started off in the Lafayette Escadrille, so he went over to Europe at the age of 17 to fight for the cause, to fight for the Allied forces. So he was even flying for the cause before the U.S. actually joined. So really cool watch. And another interesting part about Tommy Hitchcock Jr. was he was actually very influential in the development of the P-51 Mustang as we know it nowadays. He was stationed at the embassy in London, and he saw them developing the P-51 Mustang. And he actually made suggestions of them throwing the British Merlin engine in there to really give it the horsepower that plane needed to make it a high-level, high-range bomber. They added fuel tanks to it and really made it the modern P-51 Mustang, or what was the modern P-51 Mustang back then. So killer, killer watch here, guys. As you can see, the dial is laid out very much like a dashboard gauge assembly inside of the cockpit of an airplane. You have these big wide hands. This is all loom too. Stick around for the loom shot, because the loom is really impressive on this one, especially with that aviation feel to it. But it's laid out, as you guys can see, very much like a gauge, an altimeter, a speedometer in an airplane, or a flight speed, I guess, indicator in an airplane. But really cool looking timepiece. Let's talk specifications, guys. The case from side to side, not including this protective crown guard, is 43 millimeters, just under 51 lug tip to lug tip, or right about 51, 14 millimeters from the case back to the top of the dome sapphire crystal, and you're running 22 millimeter lug openings. Now, I'm going to bring it up here a little bit closer so you guys can see this, just so you can see the depth of the dial. It is a sandwich dial, so you actually have cutouts here under the 02 and up here at the 0 position, as you guys can see. But then it steps down to this other level where everything else is actually raised up above the dial. Little bit hard to capture here because we do have a dome sapphire crystal, and there's AR coating, but it's on the underside, not on the top. So we just get a lot of reflections that way. The watch is running the Seiko NH35 movement, so you get a clean sweep of that second hand. Also get date functionality down here at the 6 o'clock position. Most of you guys know this movement pretty well, but I'll go through it really quick. You have a 24 jewel movement, hacking and hand windable. So I'll go ahead and show you that. Pull the crown all the way out. It does stop that second hand. Push it all the way in, and you do have winding function here. You can wind this one. It does not have a screw down crown. It is protected on this watch, but you only have 50 meters water resistance, which is just fine for a watch like this. So get about 40 hours of power reserve out of the NH35, and it beats at a really good beat rate of 21,600 vibrations per hour. So nice looking timepiece overall. Go ahead and flip it on the side, and we'll talk about the case finish on the watch. Polishing along the side of the case here, as you can see, brushing on the tops of the lugs, also brushed on that fixed bezel that goes up to that sapphire crystal on the watch. You can see the crown guard has these little holes here in it. I do believe that those are to act as like, to look like the exhaust ports on the P-51 Mustang, I think that's why they do it. The leather strap on the watch, reminiscent of the seatbelt harness assemblies inside the older planes, the World War II planes, really nice looking there. Go ahead and undo the strap here and the buckle assembly on the watch. I'll show you, it is a signed buckle assembly. Also with the AVI-8 logo there, and brown on top with the black underneath, and you have the black keepers, which adds some really nice color to it. So 10 gold Tommy. One of the other things Hitchcock Jr. was famous for was he did attend Oxford, he attended Harvard, and he was a famous polo player, and his handicap was 10 gold. So they got the name 10 gold Tommy. Very cool there. Pretty impressive guy when you think about it. Helped develop the P-51 Mustang, went to Harvard, went to Oxford, played polo, and he actually represented the U.S. in the Olympics back in the day. So a really impressive guy. Definitely deserves to have at least a watch named after him, if not a whole lot of other things. But really nice looking timepiece, a new one from the P-51 Mustang series. Let's go ahead and throw this one on my 7-inch wrist, and then guys, stick around for that loom shot. All right, guys, so this is the watch on my 7-inch wrist. I'll admit, I don't usually wear 43-millimeter watches. 51 lug-to-lug is a little bit big for me, but this does fit on the wrist really well. It sits very nicely on my 7-inch wrist, and honestly, I don't think it looks too big. I don't think a 43-millimeter watch, excuse me, is too big. I think it actually looks pretty darn good on my wrist. So let's dim the lights and check out the lume. All right, so I'm not sure what the lume is on the watch, but it definitely has good lume, and it definitely lasts throughout the night. But definitely applied heavily too. And I love it because you just get that feel of that cockpit, that gauge assembly from a military or an aviation cockpit. I think it looks really good. So good looking timepiece. Guys, I'm not quite sure what the price will be on these things when they come out next week, but definitely follow the link down below in the description. Get yourself signed up so that when they do launch these, you guys are one of the first ones to know about it. So, all right, guys, you liked the video, give me a thumbs up down there at the bottom. And if you've not subscribed to the OFD channel yet, please do. Thanks, guys.